हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द चैनल गार्डन डायरी ऑफ स्पॉट शो। टुडे आई हैव मेड दिस वीडियो फॉर देम हु आर इन डायलेमा वेदर और नॉट टू स्टार्ट अ स्मॉल किचन गार्डन एट द टेरेस और बालकनी। मेनी पीपल हैव फियर एंड मिसकंसेप्शन दैट द प्रोसेस इज वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, नीड ह्यूज स्पेस एंड इन्वॉल्व ग्रेट अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम एंड मनी। फ्रेंड्स, go through the full video. Here I mentioned how one can grow vegetable with minimum effort and resources. On important points, I'll make separate video for each, and those who are interested may subscribe to the channel for the notifications. So, let's start the topic. First point, what to grow? Easiest to grow are the vegetables, those are right for the season.
Tomatoes, beans, capsicum, cauliflowers, broccolis, all can grow very well in winter. You can see them plenty in the market. That means they grow very easily.
Sow or plant them before winter, that means late in October. Some vegetables grow in summer, like lady's finger or bhindi, gourds, etc. Sow them in spring. And some veggies, they are year-long veggies like brinjal, chilies, etc. You can grow them anytime. Here one thing I need to say is some vegetables need trail support. If you are unable to provide the support to them, please avoid them, like gourds, cucumbers, like that. I'll soon upload a exclusive video regarding the sowing schedule. Next comes how to grow. If you're growing only one or two plant of each vegetable, you can buy saplings from nursery. Tomato, chili, brinjal, etc. are easily available at the nursery. But I personally prefer growing from seeds. I'll also post a separate video for that, stating the pros and cons of both. Next very important point is container and space. Most of the vegetables grow nicely in a 10-inch container. Bigger will be better, but 10-inch will do. You can use anything from terracotta pot to any plastic container or grow bag which hold about 10 liters of soil. You should keep about 10-inch gap between two containers to prevent overcrowding. I'll post videos of each plant I grow from seed to harvest. So stay connected, friends. Next important thing is light requirement. All vegetables grow best in full sunlight, but it does not mean they cannot be grown in balcony where 6 to 8 hours of sunlight comes. Produce may be less, but you will not be deserted, which I can assure you. Greens like dhania, mint can be grown very easily in very small containers at your windowsills. Next is potting soil. You make the potting soil by easily available materials. Just note down, you need garden soil, whichever you have, 50%. Cow dung compost, vermicompost or kitchen compost. You can use all of three, or you can use any two or one. In any ratio, you make 40%. Add 5% bone meal and 5% neem coal to that. This is the basic minimum potting requirement. If in the 50% soil, you can add cocopeat, like if you add 30% soil and 20% cocopeat to make 50%, it will be very good. It will reduce your watering effort because cocopeat holds water and makes the soil light and the container also light. If your garden soil is clayey, you can add sand to make it porous, otherwise it is not necessary. You must have heard and seen many other ingredients to be mixed in soil. They are not wrong. Here in this video, purposely I'll not mention any extra ingredient. Trust me, your yield will be great.
I have done myself.
Next comes very important topic, watering, which is very difficult to teach and you have to learn it by doing it. This is because it depends on many factors like your soil, your weather, pot size, plant cell, and it varies from plant to plant also. Some require more, some require less. If you remember simple basic principle, you will always be right.
Plants do not like soggy soil.
They like moist. So water to moisten the soil and water when it is dry. It will change from season to season for your plant. Next comes fertilizers. If you have made the soil properly with the mix which I have told earlier, you may not give any fertilizer to your seasonal vegetables. That fertilizers which have given to your soil should be enough.
But if you can manage time, you can add mustard cake ferment, and if you can manage waste decomposer, the video of which I have already uploaded, please go through it. Once in 15 days, your plant will look totally different and yield will be much higher and your plants will be much healthier. I must mention one thing here. Please don't waste any of your kitchen organic matter. Recycle them to make compost at your home using waste decomposer. It is very easy. Now, pesticides. Only neem oil will solve 90% of your pest problem if you use regularly. I am stressing on the point regularly. Spray any 1500 ppm neem oil 5 ml per liter with 5 drops of dishwater solution and spray to your plants every 10 to 15 days will not face any major problem in your garden. In case you face any problem, you may ask question here which I'll try to reply within my knowledge which I gained from the experience. Now the final part, harvesting. It is the most gratifying part of the whole exercise. Involve all family members. Learn to harvest in time. This also you will have to learn by doing. Always use sharp scissors or pruners to harvest the veggies. Don't injure the plant. By seeing this video, if anyone starts growing veggies, my effort will be fruitful. If you have liked the video, please press the like button, share with your friends and subscribe to the channel to get connected to me. Thank you very much for viewing this video.